हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ पी विजया, लेक्चरर इन केमिस्ट्री, इंदिरा प्रियदर्शनी गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन, नामपल्ली. वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल थियरी इन द चैप्टर केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. इन मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल थियरी वी आर डिस्कसिंग द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल थियरी. सो एज ऑफ नाउ वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द सैलियंट फीचर्स ऑफ मॉलिक्यूलर ऑर्बिटल थियरी एंड the homonuclear diatomic molecules. So today's question is the arranged bond orders of homonuclear diatomic molecules of oxygen. That means oxygen is having a various forms. It is having a variable oxidation states also. So in their respective oxidation states, so what will be the bond order? And we need to arrange the bond orders of in their ascending order. That means the lower bond order to the higher bond order. So let us see now what will be the answer for this one. So first thing I'm taking, first one is the O2 molecule I am taking here. So the first example O2. Let us see now what will be the bond order for O2 molecule. And for O2 molecule means in order to know a bond order of the oxygen molecule, so what will be the points? So the first point is we have to know the atomic number of each oxygen atom present in the O2 molecule. So what will be the atomic number of oxygen? That is the 8, right? So the second point is the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration of each oxygen atom in the O2 molecule. What will be the electronic configuration of atom? 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So the second orbital is the outermost orbital for the O2, means oxygen atom. And the third point is, what will be the third point? The total number of electrons, right? In O2 molecule now, I am taking a molecule now, not atom, single atom. So these two for the single atom I am taking, and this third step, the total number of electrons present in the O2 molecule I am taking. So 8 plus 8, total how many electrons are present in the O2 molecule? Each oxygen containing 8 protons means 8 electrons will be there. So here we can see these are the number of electrons. So total 8 plus 8, total 16 electrons will be there. And what will be the fourth step now? The fourth step is the construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram, right? So MOED, molecular orbital energy level diagram, energy level diagram of O2 molecule. O2 molecule. So here this side I am going to draw this molecular orbital energy level diagram. First, we have to write the arrow mark. So this represents that lower energy to higher energy level, and I am writing the outermost orbital electronic configuration only of each oxygen. So These are the atomic orbitals of one oxygen, and this side also atomic orbitals of another oxygen. Okay, and here the molecular orbitals of O2 molecule will be in the center. So I'm writing for the 2s2 electronic configuration of this oxygen now. So this is the 2s2. Okay, so two electrons will be there, and for this oxygen also there will be a two electrons, and these two electrons, when they combine with each other, they forms a molecular orbitals, equal number of the molecular orbitals. So this is a bonding molecular orbital, and this one is the anti-bonding molecular orbital. And bonding molecular orbital always represents with the sigma symbol. Anti-bonding molecular orbital will be represents with the sigma star. So since they are forming because of addition or combination of the atomic orbitals, that is 2s2. So this is also 2s2, right? So 2s2 atomic orbitals. So this is sigma 2s, and this is also sigma star 2s. Now how many electrons are there in the 2s2? 2s2 total number of electrons 4. So 4 electrons, 2 electrons will be occupied in the bonding molecular orbital, and 2 electrons will be occupied in the anti-bonding molecular orbital. Now the 2p orbitals. Let us see now the 2p atomic orbitals. The 2p atomic orbitals. 2p. Okay. So one is the 2px, 2py, 2pz. Right. So this one will be the 2px, y, pz. And the another oxygen atom is also having a 2p orbital, which is having a 4 electrons in each. So similar way to this oxygen atom, px will be there, py will be there, pz will be there. So 4 electrons, first we have to fill one electron in each, then we have to pair up the electrons. Here also same. So we have to fill one electron in each, and we have to pair up. And after this one, this two atomic orbitals, means here the three atomic orbitals are there, three atomic orbitals of another oxygen is there. So total 6 orbitals are merged together and forms a 6 molecular orbitals. Those are in them bonding molecular orbitals will be 3 and anti-bonding molecular orbitals will be 3. So for this is the oxygen that atomic number is above 7, right? So the atomic number here, it is greater than 7. It is greater than 7 atomic number of oxygen. For this, what will be the molecular orbital energy level diagram? First, the sigma 2px will form, which occupies the lower energy level, and then the 2py and pz, py orbital, so which is a pi 2py and pi 2pz, right? So and this will be the lower part of the molecular orbitals, and the next one is the in higher energy level. This is the pi star orbital, and this is also pi star orbital, and pi star 2py orbital, pi star 2pz orbital. And we need to combine all these orbital. Why we need to combine? Because these atomic orbitals are merging together and forming a, are converting into a, the molecular orbitals, right? Molecular orbitals. So the meaning of this dotted lines is this one. Now how many electrons are there? Here 4 electrons are there, here 4 electrons are there. So total number of electrons are 8. So simply you fill the 2 electrons here, and 1, 2, next pairing each other. So total 6 electrons are over now, and here one electron, here one electron. So total 8 electrons we have filled till now. This is the molecular orbital energy level diagram. And what will be the fifth point? The electronic configuration of O2 molecule, the electronic configuration of O2 molecule. So please don't confuse here. This, the second point is electronic configuration of oxygen atom present in the O2 molecule, that is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. Here we are writing this one. So on sides. So here the electronic configuration of O2 molecule means we need to write this bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals containing how many electrons. See here the 2 electrons, and here also 2 electrons, and this sigma bonding molecular orbital is having a 2 electrons, and here this is having a 1 electron in each. So in the electronic configuration, let us write the sigma 2s2, which is having a lesser energy than the sigma star 2s2 electrons, and lesser energy than the sigma 2px2 electrons, and lesser energy than the pi 2py is equivalent to pi 2pz. And how many electrons are there? 2 electrons in each are having a less energy than the pi star and 2py. 1 electron is present, and which is equivalent energy. So equivalent energy than the pi star 2pz, 1 electron. So now this, since it is having a 2 unpaired electrons, means one electron is there. So because of this unpaired electrons, which is a, what is the magnetic property? This is the paramagnetic substance, right? Paramagnetic compound or paramagnetic substance. Because of presence of unpaired electrons. Okay, because of presence of unpaired electrons present in the molecular orbitals. So this is the paramagnetic substance. And the seventh point is more important point for us now in this particular question. That is the bond order of a molecule. And bond order, how to calculate the bond order? It is the half of the difference between the electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals and antibonding molecular orbitals. The electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. So how many electrons are there in the bonding molecular orbitals? Let us check now. The 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, 8. 8 electrons are there in the bonding molecular orbitals. And minus, how many electrons are there in the antibonding molecular orbitals? 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. So 4 electrons are present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. 8 minus 4 will be the 4 divided by 2, which is equal to 2. That means each oxygen can form a double bond with the another oxygen, right? So this is the bond order. What is the bond order here? Is it 2? The bond order is 2 for the oxygen molecule, right? Then the second question is, the second one is O2 plus, right? O2 plus molecule. So what will be the bond order of O2 plus molecule? Let us see now. So in the O2 plus molecule, the same manner we have to discuss. So the first point is, what is the first point? Here this is the combination of one oxygen atom and the oxygen plus ion. Okay, so the combination of in the O2 plus is formed, the bond formed between the one oxygen and the oxygen plus ion. So let us see now, what is the oxygen, means atomic number of oxygen. Here the atomic number of oxygen is same, this will never changes. Why it is never changes? Because atomic number is nothing but the proton number, right? So atomic number of oxygen atom in the O2 molecule, which is equal to 8 for oxygen and O plus also. So this is a number never changes because it is nothing but a proton number. And the second point is, the electronic configuration will be changes, right? So electronic configuration of oxygen atom, I'm writing here, I'm taking oxygen atom, that is the 1s2 2s2 p4, right? And the third point here, I'm adding one more point, that is electronic configuration of O plus ion. So here we need to add one more point in this cases, in the diatomic, homonuclear diatomic species, and we need to give, means the electronic configuration of this is 1s2 2s2 2p4 only. This is equivalent to the atomic number of the oxygen. Number of electrons are equal to the number of protons present in this oxygen atom. But here the proton atomic number is 8. That means the protons are 8 only. But how many electrons are there? Only 7 electrons there. Why only 7 electrons? Because it has lost it one electron. So 7 electrons are there. These 7 electrons are balancing the 8 protons, positive charges of the nucleus, right? And one proton left over, because here only 7 electrons are there. 7 electrons are balancing the 7 protons, and leftover proton will be represented with the plus symbol here. So here one of the electron is less in the oxygen plus ion. So what will be the electronic configuration? It lost its electron from the 2p orbital, outermost orbital. So it will become a 2p3. By losing one electron, it becomes a 2p3. So this is the electronic configuration of O plus ion here. And what will be our fourth point? The fourth point is, now the total number of electrons present in the O2 plus molecule. O2 plus molecule. Now count the number of the electrons. Total number of the electrons. These are 8 electrons and 7. 8 plus 7 will be the 15 electrons are there. Now the fifth point is, we need to construct the molecular orbital energy level diagram, MOED, of O2 plus molecule. So here this side I am drawing this one. Okay, so this is the energy level diagram. So we should not forget to draw this one. And I am writing this outermost electronic configurations only. Okay, and here I am writing the atomic orbitals of oxygen atom, and this side I am writing atomic orbitals of O plus ion, and in center the molecular orbitals of O2 plus molecule, right? So here I am taking the O2 for a oxygen atom. So this electronic configuration I am writing, so 2s2 and this atomic orbital 2s2. Here the two electrons are present, and this will be the bonding molecular orbital which represents with the sigma symbol and 2s symbol, and the antibonding molecular orbital of oxygen molecule O2 plus ion, and which represents with the sigma star and 2s. So how many electrons will be? Total 4 electrons are there. 4 electrons will be enter in this way. So we have to connect now. Here 2 electrons are there, here also 2 electrons are there. Next one is the here p orbital, and p orbital, p atomic orbitals of oxygen, O oxygen atom, that is total 3 orbitals will be there. Suborbitals are there. One is the px orbital, py orbital and pz orbital, right? And here how many electrons are there? 2p, 4 electrons are there. So 2, 3, 4. 4 electrons are there. And here also the 2p orbitals, atomic orbitals in the O plus ion, and similarly here also px, py, pz. So the name of this particular suborbitals. And how many electrons are there here? 3 electrons only there, so that each atomic orbitals are having a 1-1 electron in each. So this is atomic number for oxygen is 8, right? So the sigma bond is acquires a lower energy sigma 2px, right? So sigma star, these are the bonding molecular orbitals, and anti-bonding molecular orbital here, this is the and pi orbitals, right? So this is pi 2p y 2p y, and here pi star orbitals, high energy orbitals, and sigma star orbital, sigma star 2p x orbital, and this is the pi star 2p y and pi star 2p z, right? So now let us combine all these atomic orbitals. We must not forget the combining the atomic orbitals also, otherwise you will lose the marks. So now here 4 electrons and 3 electrons, 4 plus 3 7, just fill like this. 2 electrons are there, and here 1-1 electron in each, then pairing will be takes place. Total 6 electrons are over, and here the pi star 2py is having only 1 electron. Let us write now in the next point, let us write here the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration of O2 plus molecule. O2 plus molecule is the electronic configuration of O2 plus molecule is here onwards we have to write in the ascending order of their energy level. So sigma 2s2 is having a lesser energy than the sigma star 2s2, and which is having a lesser energy than the sigma 2px two electrons, which is having a lesser energy than the pi, 2py. Two electrons are having equal energy almost than 2pz. Two electrons which are having a lesser energy than the pi star, 2py, one electron. Then what will be our seventh point? Since it is having a one unpaired electron here, so this is a paramagnetic substance. Paramagnetic substance, right? Paramagnetic substance. And what will be the eighth point now? The eighth point is the calculation of bond order. So which is a, what is the formula to calculate the bond order? Which is a half of the difference between the electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals and the electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals. So by 2. So BMO minus ABMO. So what is the bonding molecular orbitals? How many are there? 2 plus 2. Okay, 4. 4 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 2, 8. Total bonding molecular orbitals are having 8 electrons. And how many unpaired electrons? How many electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals? There are the 3 electrons are present divided by 2. So 5 divided by 2. 8 minus 3 will be 5. That means 2.5 will be the bond order. That means the oxygen, the bond between the oxygen are having a 2 fully fledged bonds, and 1 will be the partial bond or weaker bond will be there. So this is the molecule now. What is the bond order here? That is 2.5. The third one is in the question, the given question, the third one is O2 2 plus. So in the O2 2 plus, what will be the bond order? So what will be the bond order of O2 2 plus? Let us see now. In the O2 2 plus molecule, which is the combination of one oxygen atom plus one oxygen 2 plus ion. That means here this oxygen is having a same electrons as in the same protons, means the number of protons will be equal to the number of electrons here. Completely they are balancing, the electrons are balancing the positive charges of the this nucleus of the atom. But here this oxygen atom, by losing two electrons, it is a short of two electrons, so that only here six electrons are satisfying the six protons. The remaining two electrons it lost. So the remaining two protons are representing with the 2 plus. So this is the O2 plus ion and this is the oxygen atom. Now first, this is the first one. I am giving the explanation or details of first atom here. First oxygen atom in the O2 2 plus ion. So the atomic number of oxygen atom. I am taking oxygen atom, that is 8, right? The second point is the same atom, oxygen atom, what will be the electronic configuration of oxygen atom. So what will be the electronic configuration of oxygen atom? It is normally, it is a as it is. There is no difference here. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So how many number of protons are there? The equivalent number of the electrons will be there. And the third point I am giving about the is O2 plus ion. So for O2 plus ion, we have to remember is the atomic number is same for both. The number of protons will be same for both. Electrons, number of electrons will be different. So how many electrons are there in the O2 plus ion? Let us see now. So the electronic configuration of O2 plus ion. So it has been lost the two electrons from the p orbital here. So if we remove the two electrons, what will be the electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, p2, right? So the fourth point here is how many total number of electrons are there here? 8 electrons plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, 6 electrons. So the total number of electrons, the total number of electrons in O2 2 plus molecule is total how many? 8 plus 6 is a 14 electrons are there. So total number of electrons in O2 2 plus ion will be the 14 electrons. And now here it is time to construct the molecular orbital energy level diagram of O2 2 plus, right? O2 2 plus molecule. Now here energy level diagram, and this side I am taking atomic orbitals of oxygen atom I am taking, and this side I am taking atomic orbitals of O2 plus ion I am taking, and in between molecular orbitals of O2 2 plus molecule I am taking. So here this one, I am taking this one 2s2 for the oxygen atom. So 2s2, this will be the 2s2, that means this oxygen atom containing the 2s2 electrons, and this is also having a 2s2, right? So 2 electrons are there, and they merge it together and forms a antibonding and bonding molecular orbitals. So the combination will give molecular orbitals formation, the same number of the molecular orbitals form. So and total number of electrons, how many? 4 electrons are there. So let us fill the 4 electrons now. And this is the bonding molecular orbital which exhibits with the sigma symbol, and 2s, 2 electrons present, and this will be the antibonding molecular orbital which represents with the sigma star symbol and 2s2 electrons. And now the p orbitals, let us take a p orbitals here. So for this oxygen atom, how many p electrons are there? 2p, 4 electrons are there. So as I told you already, the px orbital, py orbital, pz orbital, total 3 orbitals, atomic orbitals are there in the oxygen, and O2 plus ion also is having the same number of orbitals only, and 2 electrons only there. So 1 orbital is remain unoccupied, and since it is a oxygen atom which is having a atomic number greater than 7, so the first least energy level will be the sigma bonding, right? Sigma bonding orbital. So 2px horizontal overlapping, and the next one will be the, these are the pi orbitals of 2py and 2pz, and here these are the pi orbitals, but antibonding pi star which represents with the pi star 2py and 2pz. So how many electrons will be there? Let us fill now after writing this antibonding sigma star 2px. So total how many electrons? 4 plus 2. How many? 6 electrons are there. So just fill the electrons in this way. So total 6 electrons are filled in the lower energy bonding molecular orbitals only here. So there are no electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals, right? So the higher energy levels are the antibonding molecular orbitals, and these are the bonding molecular orbitals. These two are the bonding molecular orbitals. Now, what will be the next point here? The next point is the electronic configuration of O2 2+ molecule. Okay, so what will be the electronic configuration? The sigma is having sigma 2s, 2 electrons is having a lesser energy than the sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, 2 electrons than sigma 2px, 2 electrons is lesser energy than pi 2px, 2py, 2 electrons are equal energy with the pi 2pz, 2 electrons. So all these are the bonding molecular orbitals only, and antibonding molecular orbitals are not there here. And the next one is the, what will be the magnetic behavior of this particular substance? Since it is having all of the paired electrons only, no unpaired electrons are there, so which is a diamagnetic substance. This substance is a diamagnetic substance. And what will be the seventh point? The calculation of bond order. So in order to calculate a bond order for this molecule, the number of electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals minus antibonding molecular orbitals, the number of electrons in the antibonding electrons divided by 2. So how many bonding molecular orbitals are having how many electrons? So this is the 2 electrons plus 2 electrons plus 2 electrons plus 2 electrons, total 8 electrons, minus antibonding is having this only 2 electrons, so divided by 2. 8 minus 2 is a 6, divided by 2, which is a 3. So what will be the bond order for this O2 plus ion? The 3 is the bond order. Okay, 3 is the bond order of a molecule. So this molecule is having a triple bond with the another oxygen atom. It can form a triple bond. So this is about O2 plus ion. And what will be the fourth point now? O2 minus, right? O2 minus molecule. Now here, this is the combination of one oxygen atom plus one O minus ion. So ion, okay. So this oxygen atom, both oxygen atom and ion are having the same number of the proton number. That means, which is nothing but the atomic number. Proton number is nothing but an atomic number. Proton number is a positive charges. But here, we need to remember here is the number of protons are equal to the number of electrons. That means, well, this positive charges of the oxygen atom nuclei will be balanced by the equal number of the negatively charged species. This electrons balances the this 8 protons. So it requires 8 electrons. It is having a 8 electrons here, 8 electrons. But here this O minus ion is having a 9 electrons. already this 8 electrons are balancing the 8 proton, but one excess electron is there that represents with the negative charge. So negative charge means means it has been taken up by one electron, right? So here 8 electrons are there and here 9 electrons are there. What will be the first point? So we have to write the details of this one, then later the details of this one and the total number of the electrons present in the O2 minus ion, right, molecule. So the atomic number of oxygen is 8, right? The second point is electronic configuration of oxygen atom. So which oxygen we are taking? This part, okay? This part we are taking now. The electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, p4, right? And the third point is about this ion. Now the electronic configuration, since the oxygen, it is also a oxygen, atomic number is same, so I'm not repeating this point now. So the electronic configuration I'm writing directly. So electronic configuration of O minus ion is, so we need to add one more electron to this outermost orbital of the oxygen. So 1s2, 2s2 and 2p will become, now 4 become 5, because we are adding one more electron, extra electron to the outermost orbital. And what will be the fourth point? The fourth point is the total number of electrons in O2 minus molecule or ion. So O2 minus molecule. So total how many number of the electrons are there? Here 8 electrons are there, here 9 electrons. So total 17 electrons are present in the O2 minus molecule. And what will be our fifth point? The construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram of O2 minus molecule. O2 minus molecule. So this side I am drawing the, constructing the molecular orbital energy level diagram here. Okay, so energy, and this side I am taking the atomic orbitals of oxygen atom I am taking. Okay, this side I am taking atomic orbitals of O minus ion, this one, okay, so minus ion. And in between the molecular orbitals that of O2 minus. So the molecular orbitals I am taking in the center. And the first one is the 2s2. For oxygen atom, the electronic configuration I am taking 2s2, which is combining with the 2s2 atomic orbital of O minus ion. Okay, 2s2. And they are forming a bonding molecular orbital and anti-bonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital and anti-bonding molecular orbital. So this is represents with the sigma. This is represents with the sigma star. Okay. So okay, two electrons, so here 2 electrons and here also 2 electrons. So these are combining with each other, and this is the 2s2 and this 2s2. The next one is the p orbital is merging with the p orbital of O minus ion, right? So p orbital of oxygen atom, which is having a 2p4 in its atomic orbital, so they are arranged in this way. And this atomic orbitals of O minus ion is having 2p5 electrons, so they are arranged in this way. First 3 electrons, then we need to pair up. And since it is the oxygen atom which is having atomic numbers more than 7, so the sigma bond first it will form, that means it is having a less energy. So this is the sigma 2px. This is formed between the px orbital of atomic orbitals of the oxygen atom and oxygen ion, and it will be the combination of pi orbitals will be the formed by the combination of pi 2py and pi 2pz. Both are having a same energy levels. So total how many 9 electrons are there? First let us write a orbitals, then assign pi star, and this is the combination of 2py orbital, this is the combination of 2pz orbital, and this is the sigma star, which is the combination of 2px, right? So total how many electrons now? 9 electrons are there. So just let us fill the 9 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9th electron I am filling here only. Then just join them properly. Okay, so this is the molecular orbital energy level diagram of O2 minus. And what will be the 6th point? The electronic configuration. Of O2 minus molecule. So what will be the electronic configuration of this one is the just in ascending order we have to write from bottom to top. So sigma 2s2 is having a lesser energy than the antibonding molecular orbital. Sigma star 2s2 is lesser energy than the bonding molecular orbital. Sigma 2px, 2 electrons are having a lesser energy than pi. 2py is having a 2 electrons, and this is having a equal energy than pi 2pz, which is having a lesser energy than pi star 2py, 2 electrons, and which is having a lesser energy than pi 2p star pi star 2p z, only 1 electron. Okay, these are the bonding molecular orbitals, and these are the antibonding molecular orbitals, right? So now, is there any unpaired electrons are there? Yes, we have one unpaired electron is there in the molecular orbital of O2 minus. So in because of this presence of one unpaired electron, which is acts as a paramagnetic substance. And what is the paramagnetic substance? When it is placed under the external magnetic field, it will be attracted by the external magnetic field. And what will be our next point? That is the 8th point. So the important one is the bond order. And this, what is the formula of bond order? Is the difference between the number of electrons present in the bonding molecular orbitals minus antibonding molecular orbitals. means electrons present in the antibonding molecular orbitals are divided by 2. So how many number of electrons are there? This is the bonding molecular orbital, this is the bonding molecular orbital, these two are the bonding molecular orbitals, okay, and remaining ones, star ones, are the antibonding molecular orbitals. So 2 plus 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 2, 8 electrons are there, minus in antibonding molecular orbitals 2 plus 2, 4 plus 1, 5. So 8 minus 5 is the 3, 3 divided by 2. So which will give the bond order will be 1.5. That means the oxygen is having a one fully fledged bond, stronger bond between the another O minus ion, and also the partial bond will be takes place between the this oxygen. So the this one bond is stronger bond, stable bond, and another bond is the weaker bond. So this is the bond order. 1.5 is the bond order for the O2 minus molecule. Then the next one is the fifth one, O2 2 minus molecule. So this is formed because of the combination of one oxygen atom and another one is the O2 minus. That means this is having a 8 protons and 8 electrons. Here 8 electrons are there. Here the 2 minus means this is the by adding 2 more electrons to the oxygen atom, which results O2 minus. So here the 10 electrons are there present in the O2 minus ion. So what will be our first point? The first point will be the atomic number of oxygen atom. So this is the oxygen atom, right? So that is 8. And second point is the electronic configuration of oxygen atom, that is 1s2, 2s2, p4. And the third point is about this ion, right? Ion. So the electronic configuration of O2 minus ion. So how many electrons are there in the O2 minus ion now? So to this, 2 more electrons we need to add, right? So 1s2, 2s2, p6. So it is attaining the stability, this O2 minus ion. Then next point is the total number of electrons. The total number of electrons in O2 2 minus molecule. So total number of electrons is, this is the 8 electrons present and here 10 electrons. Total how many? 18 electrons are present. And what will be our fifth point? That is the construction of molecular orbital energy level diagram of O2 2 minus molecule, right? Molecule. So this side I am drawing here. This side I am drawing. And we have to write the arrow mark in upper. border side. It represents the energy level, okay, from the lower energy to the higher energy. So here we should not forget the writing the E symbol also. And this sign I am writing atomic orbitals of atom, oxygen atom, and here I am writing atomic orbitals of O2 2- ion, and in between molecular orbitals of O2 2-. So here this orbitals are combining with this orbital of O2-. So here the 2s2 atomic orbital of 2s2 is combining with the atomic orbital of O2-, that is 2s2 atomic orbital 2s2 of O2- ion. So here this is having a 2 electrons and here also 2 electrons, and which results, the combination results the bonding molecular orbitals and anti-bonding molecular orbitals sigma star, and this represents with the sigma symbol, right? So here total 4 electrons are there. By combination, all the 4 electrons will be enter into the molecular orbitals, right? So here 2 electrons and here also 2 electrons. The next one is the 2p orbital. So this 2p orbital of oxygen atom is merging with the 2p orbital of O2- ion. So here this is the oxygen atom configuration, that is 2p4. So each orbital of p is having the electrons in this way, and O2- is having how many electrons? 2p6 electrons are there. 2p6, these are the atomic orbitals of the O2-. So all are having a paired electrons in this way, 2p6, and since this is a oxygen atom, first it will form a sigma 2px. The combination will give, means the overlapping of px will give the sigma, and then the combination of 2py, 2py will give the pi 2py, and the combination of pz, pz will give the pi 2pz orbital, molecular orbital, and these are the lower energy levels, so bonding molecular orbitals, and the upper ones are the anti-bonding molecular orbitals, which represents a star symbol, and this is the combination of px orbitals, and these are results in the combination of 2py and pi star 2pz. So now let us combine all orbitals with the dotted lines. So now how many electrons are there? 14 electrons are there. So 2 electrons we are filling here, 3rd electron, 4th electron, means 1 electron we have to fill, 5th electron, 6th electron pairing we need to do. So 6 electrons are filled now. So how many electrons left? Total 14 electrons, no? So 6 electrons are over. Sorry, 10 electrons. Among the 10 electrons, 14 electrons we filled. 10 electrons, 6 electrons are filled. So one electron and then pair. So how many? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Total 10 electrons we filled. And now we need to write the number of electrons in the molecular orbital. So 2 here, 2 here, 2 here, and 2 here, 2 here. So the next point will be the electronic configuration of इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ O2-2- मॉलिक्यूल. Okay, so what will be the electronic configuration? Now we need to write sigma 2s2 is having a lesser energy than the sigma star 2s2 is lesser energy than the sigma 2px is having a lesser energy than the pi 2py. Two electrons are having equal energies with the 2pz, two electrons, and which are having a lesser energy than the pi star 2py, two electrons are having lesser energy, sorry, equal energy than the pi star 2pz, two. Okay, this is the electronic configuration of the molecular orbitals. And then the next point, the seventh point, will be the magnetic behavior. So is there any unpaired electrons are present? No. So all these are the paired electrons only. So there are no unpaired electrons present. This will be acts as a diamagnetic substance. Diamagnetic substance means what? So which will be repelled by the external magnetic field when they placed. Okay, so diamagnetic substance. And the next point is, eighth point is the calculation of bond order. And what is will be the formula for the bond order, calculation of the bond order? The difference in the electrons present in bonding molecular orbitals and the electrons present in the anti-bonding molecular orbitals divided by 2. So this will be the formula for calculation of the bond order. So how many electrons are there? So this is bonding electrons 2 + 2 + 4 + 2 + 6 electrons, 7, 8 electrons. So 8 bonding electrons are there. Anti-bonding electrons are 2 + 2 = 4, 4 + 2 = 6. So 8 - 6 will give us 2/2. So the bond order will be 1. That means this, the bond takes place between the oxygen and the O2- will be only single bond. So the bond order, now our question, the answer for our question is, so O2- is having lesser bond energy, sorry, bond length, O2-2-. O2-2- is having a lesser bond bond order. That means which is having only one bond order is 1, and which is the least one. In the ascending order, we have to write means lower bond order to higher bond order than the O2-, which is having a 1.5, and it is less than O2-, which is having a 2 double bond, means between the in two oxygen atoms, double bond will be formed, and then the which is less than the O2+, that means which is having a 2.5 bond order, and then the O2-2+, so that means which is having a 3 bond order, 3. So total the ascending order of the bond orders will be O2-, O2-2-, O2-, O2+, O2-2+. So total how many electrons are present in the O2 molecule? O2 molecule is having a 16 electrons, and O2 plus molecule, total number of electrons present in a O2 plus is 15 electrons are there, and O2 2 plus is having a 14 electrons only, and here O2 minus is having a 17 electrons, and O2 2 minus is having a 18 electrons. So as the number of electrons are decreases, the bond order is increasing, and number of electrons are increases, the bond order is decreasing. So the shorter bond order, the bond strength will be more. So in this the bond order is more, then the bond takes place between the oxygen molecule will be a stronger bonds. So this O2 molecule is having a double bond O, and this O2 plus is having a 2.5, right? So two double bond will be there, and the third bond will be the weaker bond, and this O2 2 plus, which is having a triple bond between the oxygen atoms, and this is having a oxygen, means oxygen single bond and one double bond, that means weaker bond will be there, okay? And this molecule is having a O single bond. So this will be the bond order for our question. By this, I am stopping this video. Thank you.